So now we move to the next CPU scheduling method, that is the round robin. To understand the round robin, we have to understand a very basic definition of time quantum. टाइम क्वांटम टाइम की वो यूनिट है जिसको जिसके लिए हम अपनी हर प्रोसेस को एग्जीक्यूट कराते हैं जितने देर के लिए. फॉर एग्जांपल अगर हमने अपना टाइम क्वांटम सेलेक्ट किया है 2, सो वी एग्जीक्यूट ईच प्रोसेस बाय 2 एंड मूव टू द नेक्स्ट प्रोसेस वेदर इट इज कंप्लीटेड और नॉट. एंड इफ इट इज कंप्लीटेड बिफोर द टाइम क्वांटम एक्सपायर्स देन वी ऑटोमेटिकली मूव टू द नेक्स्ट प्रोसेस. वी चेक ईच प्रोसेस at completion and when the time quantum expires. Let us understand this by an example. The time quantum that we are selecting here is of 2 seconds. इसमें हम लोग को एक बेसिक चीज ये समझनी है. जैसे हमारे 3 प्रोसेसेस 4 प्रोसेसेस में भी कंसिडर कर लेते हैं रेडी क्यू में लगे हैं. सो फर्स्ट हम ए को एग्जीक्यूट करेंगे फॉर 2 सेकेंड्स, देन वी मूव टू बी एंड एग्जीक्यूट फॉर 2 सेकेंड्स, अगेन वी मूव टू सी एंड एग्जीक्यूट फॉर 2 सेकेंड्स, and moving to D, we execute it for 2 seconds, and again we come to the front and complete this process until each process is completed. So let us understand round robin with the help of an example. Let us have 4 processes, namely A, B, C and D, which have the arrival time and burst time as follows. We have to calculate the waiting time and the turnaround time. Now, at time t is equal to 0, also we have the time quantum defined 2 seconds here. So at t is equal to 0, we have only a single process A which have the burst time of 7. So let us make the Gantt chart. First, A is executed for 2 seconds. Now at time t is equal to 2, again, and here we have to minus 2. So the process of A remaining burst time is 5. Now no new process has arrived. So we again execute A for the next 2 seconds. And it becomes 3. Now A is executed till 4 and the remaining burst time is 3. Now at time t is equal to 4, we have A which has the burst time of 3. Now we have B which has the burst time of 4 and we have C which has the burst time of 3. Now we move to the next item in the queue, that is B, and execute it for 2 seconds. So it goes till 6. Now at time t is equal to 6, we have A is equal to 3, B is equal to 2, C is equal to 3 and D is equal to 1. So we execute the next item C for 2 seconds. So the remaining time burst time of C is 1. Now at time t is equal to 8, we have A is equal to 3, B is equal to 2, C is equal to 1 and D is equal to 1. So we execute the next item D for 1 second. So it goes up to 9 seconds. Now at time t is equal to 9 seconds, we have A is equal to 3, B is equal to 2, and C is equal to 1. So we again move to the first item in the queue, that is A, and execute it for 2 seconds, and it goes till 11. Now at t is equal to 11 seconds, we have A is equal to 1, B is equal to 2, and C is equal to 1. So we execute the next item B for 2 seconds and it goes till 13. Now at t is equal to 13 seconds, we have A is equal to 1 and C is equal to 1. So now we execute C for 1 second. So it goes till 14. Now at t is equal to 14 seconds, we have only a single process A. So now we execute it for 1 second and it goes till 15. Now we have to calculate the waiting time and the turnaround time. First we calculate the turnaround time by subtracting the completion time and the arrival time. So the completion time of A is 15 while the arrival time is 0. So 15 minus 0 is 15. The completion time of B is 13 and the arrival time is 3. So the waiting time is 10. Turnaround time is 10. And the completion time of C is 14 and the arrival time is 4. So turnaround time is 10. And that of D is 9 minus 5, which equals 4. Now we have to calculate the waiting time, which can be calculated by subtracting the turnaround time and the burst time. So now here for process A, the turnaround time is 15 and the burst time is 7, so it comes out to be 8. For process B, it is 10 minus 4, which equals 6. For process C, it is 10 minus 3, which equals 7. And for process D, it is 4 minus 1, which equals 3. Now we calculate the average waiting time by adding all the values of the waiting time divided by the total number of process, which comes out to be 6. And now we calculate the average turnaround time by adding all the turnaround times divided by the total number of process, which comes out to be 9.75. So this is the round robin process CPU scheduling algorithm, and it has the complete fairness schemes in it, as each process gets equal time to execute and there is no starvation in this scheduling algorithm.